everybody. Here we are all ready to take you down to Pine Ridge for another visit with Lum and Abner. Brought to you by the member by the makers of Horlicks, the original malted milk. Speaking of Horlicks, have you ever thought of it as a cool, refreshing drink for summer? Next time you prepare your Horlicks malted milk, add the powder to cold water or milk instead of hot, and then mix in your usual way. Cold Horlicks, cool in the refrigerator for even better results, is a perfect drink for hot days and nights. Make up some Horlicks tonight and keep a pitcher of it handy in the refrigerator for the unexpected guest or for those thirsty youngsters of yours. Horlicks, you know, is a grand drink for children. If you don't have any Horlicks malted milk, get a package from your druggist in either natural or chocolate flavor. Remember that for fine flavor, for quality and results, be sure to insist on Horlicks, the original. And now, let's see what's happening down in Pine Ridge. Well, Lum and Abner announced that their new theater, the Pine Ridge Planetarium, would open with a matinee this afternoon and invited all the children of Pine Ridge as their guests for the preview. As we look in on the old cotton warehouse that has been converted into a theater, there is a large crowd gathered out in front. And we find Lum and Abner inside. Evidently, something has gone wrong. Listen.
Now, why don't we just let them all in anyway, Lum?
No, we can't do that, Abner. We're getting bad torn up.
Well, we've got to do something. They're all out there wanting in. I bet there's 200 children out there. I never know there's that many young'uns in Pine Ridge.
Well, I reckon I may as well go out there and tell them the show's called off till we can get this thing straightened out.
Why, yeah, there's no use to keep them standing out there.
Well, open the door there, and I'll get up on this chair and try to explain to them.
Can't blame old Sister Simpson anyway. I hate that old woman to pieces. Fancy up, Leslie. Are you ready?
Yeah, open the door. Ladies and gentlemen, quiet, everybody, please. Just a minute, please.
Yeah, I'm going to make a speech. Quiet.
Let's have it quiet, please. Ladies and gentlemen and children, I've got an announcement that I hate to make, but it just looks like there ain't no way out of it. We advertised that we'd have a free matinee here this afternoon for you children, and we aim to do it. I hate to disappoint you, but the Ladies Uplift League of Pine Ridge come over in a body a while ago and told me and Mr. Peabody that they wouldn't allow this picture of ours to be showed in Pine Ridge. Why, I can't tell you. We've looked at the picture ourselves and can't see no reasons they could object to us showing it, but they do.
Yeah, it's an awful good picture. It's about a girl from a city, and her uncle died out in Arizona and left her a ranch, and she come out
there. They don't want to hear about the picture, for sure.
Well, I just thought being they weren't going to get to see it, I could just tell them about it.
Well, quit interrupting me here. Now, I can't tell you when we'll be opened up. We're aiming on having a grand opening tomorrow night and showing this same picture, but I reckon now we'll have to wait till we can order another picture out here.
Yeah.
We're awful sorry we had to disappoint you today, but to make up for it, the first night we're open for business, we're going to let all you children in free.
I will. I mean, that's fine.
We'll let you all know. We'll make an announcement over the party line just as quick as we know when we have our grand opening. I want to thank you all for coming out today and tell you again that we're awful sorry. That's all. Close the door, Abner. Close it. I never hated to do anything so bad in my life.
Yeah, they were awful disappointed, Lum. You could just see their little faces drop when you told them.
Oh, yeah.
Poor little young.
Like giving them something and then taking it away from them.
Yeah.
I feel downright ashamed of myself over it.
Well, all me, Lum, you couldn't help it. It weren't our fault.
No. I hope that blamed up police league is satisfied now. Knocking all them young'uns out of seeing a show that they'd all enjoy.
Yeah, yeah.
First time most of them's ever had a chance to see a picture show.
Well, what all did the women have to say, Lum?
Well, directly after you went home to eat, me and Dick Huddleston were sitting in here talking about the show for this afternoon, and directly the door opened, and in walked Sister Simpson and the Widder Abernathy and Mose Mooch's woman and Mamie Seastrunk. And said they represented the Ladies Uplift League of Pine Ridge and handed me a note and sewed their heads in the air and pushed out of here.
Well?
Sister Simpson a leading and the rest of them a following.
Never said a word, huh?
Well, they never had to say nothing. They had it all wrote out on a sheet of paper.
What did it say? Or, I mean, what did it have wrote on it?
Well, it just said that, wait a minute, I've got it here somewhere. I think I get my pocket. Yeah. Here it is. It says, we, the members of the Ladies Uplift League of Pine Ridge, do hereby resolve that the picture known as the Texas Kid is not a suitable picture for the young people of our community to see. We therefore demand that the owners of the Pine Ridge Planetarium refrain from showing it in their theater. Signed. And all the members are signing down here. Now, every woman in town, including your woman, Elizabeth.
Elizabeth?
Yes, sir, right there. Elizabeth Peabody.
Yeah, that's her handwriting, all right. Well, I'll be dead blamed if I don't tell her a thing or... Yes, I might as well just let it go. I don't see yet, though, how they can keep us from showing it if we're minded to do it.
Well, they can't legally.
Well, I don't believe in letting a bunch of women run our business for us.
Well, Abner, we just can't afford to get the whole town down on us right here at the start. Before we even get opened up here, you might say. See, might not every woman in town belongs to that league. They'd about boycott our theater. I say they'd boycott our theater more than likely.
Is that pretty bad?
Well, what I mean is they might make another resolve over at one of their meetings not to never come to a show. And if they wouldn't come, they wouldn't let their families come, so they'd stop the show business right there.
Well, if they ain't going to let us show no pictures, why they couldn't come to the show nohow.
Well, tell you the truth, Abner, me and Dick talked about it before he left, and we decided if they're going to raise such a fuss about it, why, we'd go ahead and humor them one time. And then when it's all over, why, they'll feel sort of sheepish about it and try to make up for it by getting us all the business they can.
Yeah.
And we can advertise that the Pine Ridge Planetarium is cooperating with the Ladies Uplift League and bringing the best moving pictures to Pine Ridge. Then they'll break their necks to come out to see what we're putting on so we won't put nothing over on them. I grannies, I bet they don't miss the show.
Oh, yeah, sure, I hadn't thought about that. Now, that is a good idea.
Well, I studied it all over careful, and I'm proud now I never said nothing out of the way to them.
No.
I reckon this is about the first time anybody's ever agreed with them on anything since they've had that club story. They're always poking their nose into somebody's business.
Yeah, old Kenneth Weehunt sure run them out of his blacksmith shop when they come down there and try to make him quit letting the fellas pitch horseshoes.
Yeah, I heard about that. He ought to have pitched a horseshoe right around that scrawny little neck of Sister Simpson. Just make a ringer right there on her neck.
Wonder what that'd count.
I don't know, but he'd have win, I'm bound.
Well, I still can't understand what objections they'd have to that picture. I never seen nothing out of the way about it.
Why, of course not.
I looked at it 6 times.
What do they know about it anyway? They haven't even saw it.
That doggy, we ought to just bring them all down here and let them see it for themselves.
Wait a minute. Now, that ain't a bad idea, Abner, right there. Why didn't we think about that?
I did. Just now I thought of it.
I mean, why didn't we think of it while they were down here?
Well, I never even know nothing about it till just a while ago. I couldn't have thought of it.
I don't know, though. They'd more than likely be too stubborn. They wouldn't change their minds now after they've come out and declared themselves that way.
Well, law me, Lum, if they're going to object to this picture, why, they will anyone that we bring out here.
Yeah, I'm getting disgusted with the whole thing. If they're going to be trying to run things for us, we may as well just close up right now.
Well, I'd hate to do that after spending all this money getting opened up.
Yeah, I would, too. I don't know. It just looks like everything in the world has happened to keep us from opening up.
Yeah, first it was Squire Skimp, and now it's a lady duck, please.
That's what I hate about it. I thought we had this thing figured out to where we'd get our show opened up first. Looks like now that we ain't got a chance, because Squire's going to open up tonight, sure.
Yeah, why don't they just go over there and stop his show if they want to stop something? Him with them fancy leprechaun lights out there in front of
them. Well, Abner, it just looks like every time we get into anything outside the store business, everything goes wrong.
Yeah.
Here we started out to do something for the town, putting in its first picture show. And then Squire had to bob up and put one in, too. Now then, the Ladies Uplift League is butting in and keeping us from opening up.
Well, it just looks like that we've joined up partners with hard luck on them, it sure does.
I don't know what to do. I'm about ready to take out. The only good I can see that we did is just fix up this old cotton warehouse.
Well, you can't guess where I've been.
Well, what's that, Dick?
I got some good news for you.
Well, for goodness sake. I went over to Sister Simpson, got her to call a meeting of the Uplift League, and I had a little talk with them. You was at the meeting yourself?
Yes, sir, and I got to the bottom of this whole thing. Found out that Squire Skimp is at the bottom of the whole business.
Well, Squire Skimp?
Well, he ain't dying the woman's Uplift League, has he?
Well, I see. If he's a member of the Uplift League, no wonder they stopped him.
No, he isn't going to jail, I don't think. But he called Sister Simpson yesterday afternoon and told her that this picture wasn't suitable for the young people of the town to see.
And that's the reason that they're raising such a fuss about it.
Well, I'll be dead.
Well,
might have known that.
Oh, I just explained to him why he started such a tour of that. They showed him how he was using their organization to fight competition. I told him I'd guarantee that this picture is all right. So they agreed to let you go ahead and run.
Well, good for you.
Oh, you told him that's why I just made all that up, huh?
Yeah, I just told him that he was using them to hurt your business over here. That's all he's doing. And are they mad? They all got up, took a stand and vote. The boy got his picture show over there.
Well, what do you know about
that? And not only that, but I was talking to Cedric Weehunt on my way over here just now. He's been in the county seat to get the film for Squire's show tonight. You know, it's supposed to come in on afternoon train.
Yeah.
And it didn't come.
It never come in?
No.
Well,
so
I
you
do.
Fellas can still beat him opening up. Have a matinee tomorrow afternoon and beat him.
All right, Granny, just let me get to the telephone. I want to make an announcement on the party line.
Well, it looks like our old friends will be the first to open a picture show in Pine Ridge after all. Ladies and gentlemen, one other thing before we leave the air. I want you to hear what one of Lum and Abner's friends say about Horlicks. If you have trouble sleeping at night, his experience may easily prove very helpful to you.
Your subject on one of last week's broadcasts was sleepless nights. Well, that was my trouble to a tease. I've always had difficulty getting a good night's rest. Drink a glass of Horlicks malted milk, you said, hot, just before going to bed. So next day, I purchased a small bottle to try. I mixed the powder with hot water, just like your announcer said, drank it, and as far as I can remember, fell asleep in the next 5 minutes. Boy, did I sleep that night. Even then, I could scarcely believe it was the Horlicks, but the next few nights convinced me that for proper sleep, Horlicks has got it over everything. You may be sure I'm telling all my friends. And here's wishing Lum and Abner and Horlicks the best of luck in the future.
If you don't get the sleep you need, see if Horlicks won't prove as helpful to you as it has to thousands all over the world. You can get Horlicks, you know, from your drugstore in either natural or chocolate flavor. This is Carlton Bricker speaking for Lum and Abner and Horlicks, who now bid you all good night and good health.